to get a real estate life. I am at Gulf Shores right now, and I am looking at the most beautiful beach. But you may hear the waves in the background, and yes, I do have some beach hair going on. So
I like it.
I am super excited to bring to you success stories, and everybody has their own style of dominating and getting out in the market and, really conquering this business. And I want to introduce to you to my friend, Erin Pons. Thank
Hello.
you so much for being here. And my gosh, you have just like, first of all, you moved to a new city recently
Yes.
where
Less
I
than a
like,
year ago.
and how many people do you know there?
Well, when we moved here, we knew two, and then, well, two and a half if you count a 4-year-old. So, yeah,
So,
two and a half.
getting your real estate license and being in a brand new city where you don't have family and you do have, a really good friend there, but that's about it getting started. I mean, how scary is that?
It was super scary, and then it was like, what am I doing?
Ha.
It's like it's a double whammy being new to a new area, 3.5 hours away from home. Like I said, knowing like 2.5 people roughly, to start with, and then of course starting a new career. It's definitely still intimidating and daunting, because all my connections are in Birmingham and the surrounding, the greater Birmingham area. So it's like, well, maybe if I would have, started up there, that'd have been easy, to off the get-go, knowing so many people. And then, because everybody's talking about your sphere of influence, I got two.
Yeah, I did the same thing when I moved to Birmingham. I didn't know anybody, didn't have any family, any friends, just really no connections at all. So I do know how scary that is. And you are, share where you do live now.
So we live in Dothan, so we are southeast Alabama, the Wiregrass area. It's kind of like how Birmingham is really encompassed of like Vestavia, home, all the way to like Gardendale and like south and all that kind of stuff. So Dothan is where we live. The Wiregrass area is kind of like all the surrounding areas like Enterprise, Headland, Ozark, all this kind of stuff. So we're 90 miles from Panama City. So yeah.
Which I love. I know I was like, how, can you meet me in Gulf Shores? And you're like, no.
Everybody does that. Everybody thinks it's like I'm like opposite side of the state.
Right.
Wrong coast. South, but on the other side. Yeah. So we're actually we're just kind of right dab in the middle. We can be in Georgia in like 15 minutes across the state line, and I can be in Florida within 15 minutes across the state line. So we're like at the little bitty corner over here.
So you'll have some more markets that will open up to you as well as you get more experienced. But
Yes.
how long have you been licensed now?
So, I have a fit. Let's see, they issued my license August 5th of this year. That's
Love that.
why I was like, "Are you sure you want me on here? Because I have to text you
Yes, of course I do. And now I've got to move a little bit. So the everything there, that lighting. There, I can see
look
it
fabulous. I'm
now.
loving the beach curls. It's so humid out here. I'm sitting outside too for better lighting. My hair is going to start to look like
It just does. That's why I wasn't going to fight it. I've got something I've got to teach in just a little bit live here in Gulf Shores. But so you've been licensed for a very short time, and how many pendings do you have?
So I have right now I have four buyers under contract, and I have one person working on getting pre-approved that they want to work with me. I have another couple who's already said that I actually released them. Like, so I've been using Opcity right now, through realtor.com as just some leads, because I don't have to pay anything on the top end. I just pay on the back end. And so they've sent me some. They sent me a ton. I've wasted a lot of time on some of those, but I actually released a couple of people because they weren't responding, and it was really funny. I actually had one realtor actually called me and was like, "Hey, you release these people, and they're not like ready to jump right now, but they said they just want to work with you." And I was like, "Okay." So I messaged a girl. I was like, "Well, just let me know when you're ready, because I don't want to keep like harassing you." And she was like, "No, it's all good." And then I have another guy, same thing. I released him because I just didn't think he was ready to buy. And he reached back out because I'd already done an in-person meeting with him, first-time home buyer, kind of walking through the process. I feel like he kind of made a connection with me because he's young too. And so we're working on getting him pre-approved. And as soon as we get that, we are going to hit the ground running. So
Well, and I love that that you released them, and they said, "Oh no, 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 no! You are my agent, and you're the person I want to work with." And so, a couple of things that you said that were super important is I'm trying to find the right angle.
You look beautiful. You're great.
I want to drop this off the balcony.
That's what I said. This is on the very edge of my seat right here. I was like, if I push it back any farther, it's just going to go.
Well, and the reason though that these people want to work with you is because you are doing things the right way. And how many buyer consultations have you actually completed?
Okay, so actually completed. Like we actually met, not necessarily signed a contract with me though, right? Just
right
in-person consultations. Let's see. So the four I have, 5, 6, and 7. So out of the 7 people that I actually conversed with and went over everything, only one person I completely released because they just kind of walked away. What do you call it? Where they ghost you.
And which, you know, for agents watching this, I mean, everybody knows that.
And I had another girl who ghosted me. She told me she was going to show up. I talked to her like an hour before our meeting. She never showed up, and to this day still had never responded. So, sorry, 2 ghosted me.
And that's actually going to happen. But what's important is that you are actually scheduling those appointments. So you touched on a little bit using Opcity, and those leads are provided how?
Those leads are provided through an app. And so all you have to do is talk to your, you know, broker. And so David Lucas, I know I have a new broker now in the South, but David was the acting for the Southeast. And he just sent me the link and signed up, and you and I talked about it. I kind of hit the ground running. I signed up for it. And 15 minutes after I signed up for it, I think I had been licensed, what, maybe a few days. And it was like claim. And I didn't even hesitate. I just like claimed it. It was like, hardly no money, but I didn't care. I was just like, let's do this. And then I didn't know what I was doing. And I didn't know like how it worked. And so like immediately it was like, you've won. And I was like, score, adrenaline rush. And then it was like realtor.com called me and like, you ready to talk to somebody? I was like, oh God, no, but okay, let's do this.
I thought I won already.
I thought I won. Like I didn't know what was coming next. And so I just got on the phone and I was like, look, I'm a board nurse practitioner. I've walked into rooms never knowing people, you know, every day of the last 11 years, had to walk into a room and automatically try to connect with somebody and get, you know, convince somebody to trust me. And just, and the way I've always done that is to be myself. You know, I'm not trying to, I don't really want to sell anybody on it. I just want people to be like, hey, this is me. You don't want to work with me, you're not going to hurt my feelings. You know, this is who I am. I just want somebody, I want to be like, I trust her. We're going to have fun. And that's what I kind of just want my brand to be. I just want people to feel like they're hanging out with a friend that they can trust, that has their back. And that's just kind of how I do all my consultations. I just try to be completely transparent with people and just, you know, get a feel for them. Hey, this is what I'm about. And I whip out that buyer contract. Don't have any sellers yet, but I'm coming for you. Somebody's going to let me sell their
You will.
But, you know, I've presented it to all, you know, all my buyers. I feel like that one of the first classes I took in EXP world, they were talking about buyer agency, and a lot of times people don't. And some agents were sharing how they have not had one and not gotten paid. And I'm like, I'm not working for free. Like I'm not about to work up to 6 months and not get paid, you know? So when I present it to people, I just say, hey, you know, I go through like how it entitles me, how you actually go from a customer to a client. I go over all the responsibilities that then it makes me a part of and how that relationship now shifts. I tell them pretty much when you sign this contract, you have the right to blow up my phone nonstop. And I tell them, I'm like, would you, if your boss came to you today and was like, hey, I need you to work on a project for up to the next 6 months and you may or may not get paid. You gonna do it? And they're like, no. And I'm like, well, that's what a buyer agency agreement is for. It just guarantees me that I'm gonna get paid, and it makes sure that you and I are both aligned, and it puts me to work for you. And that's just kind of how I sell it. And every time I've whipped it out, I've never had anybody hesitate to sign it. Everybody's like, no, I wouldn't work for free. My boss came to me with a project. I'd be like, pass.
So I hope that for the agents watching that you really internalize that, because, you know, so many people are afraid to talk about money, when it comes to dealing with clients or customers. And a lot of times people will say, oh, it doesn't cost you anything, or it's free, it's absolutely free to you. Well, if you put on your buyer agency agreement and that you are charging zero, then that's exactly what people will think that you're worth.
No, I have it after talking to my awesome mentor. Her name's Jenny Williams. You might know her. You know, you told me, like, don't be afraid, because I know the value that I'm bringing to the table. I know how hard I'm going to work for these people. And so on the contract, I just have it listed. You know, we came up with the percentage, if not listed in the MLS. And I just let people know, I'm like, this is in case that we find it for sale by owner. And a lot of times we can negotiate that in the deal. But if not, this is saying that, yes, you will be responsible for up to this percentage to pay me. But it's because I'm not going to work for free and not be guaranteed something. And, you know, we do everything up front. We put a whole lot of everything on the line, you know, the effort and the time. And I'm like, it is just, you know, I'm getting paid, and no one has hesitated. And I told him, I was like, you know, if we find a house that they don't want to pay, or if we're sell by owner, you know, I'll do my best to negotiate this. And everybody's been really receptive and understands, because no one works for free.
Well, actually, there are probably a lot of agents that do work for free.
Yes, yes, yes. I will say, the one person I did not do a agreement with, it was a really funky situation. And I was like, okay, I'll show a house first. I just got the ding from Op City. They're trying to send me some more people right now. I should have snoozed it. Don't want my score to go down. I'm like constantly, like, I'm a credit score with my agent score on there. You know, if it drops a point, I get mad. Like, no. But I don't even remember what I was saying. I'm a little ADD sometimes on these things.
Well, you were just saying you had an unusual situation that you would go show a house.
I talked about the agreement, but I didn't get it signed. And maybe in the future this will work out, and I was trying to kind of build a relationship for the long haul, but guess what? It wasted my time.
There you go.
So that's what I've learned off the bat. Like, and this is one thing I feel like a buyer's agency has done for me. It's weeded out the people who aren't really serious. Serious
right.
people won't hesitate to sign that, because they want someone to go to work for them. And they know that, hey, like, you're legit, you're serious, you're going to go to work for me, I'm going to sign. The minute you start to mention that to somebody who's not serious, it just is automatically to me like a red flag, like, hey, I'm going to waste your time.
Absolutely. And Mickey, I agree with you 100%. He just put in a comment that every new agent should hear this. And I agree. And so, Erin, you've gotten your very first one came from an agent in your
marketplace. Kelly Ford.
Yes, Kelly is awesome. She is an agent in Dothan, and she was out of town. So it's super important as a new agent, just from that situation, to network with the experienced agents in your market, because you never know when an opportunity will come up.
I think too, like, a lot of people look at other agents, even I don't think so much as EXP. I really honestly haven't experienced that. I mean, I drank the Kool-Aid, so I'm like part of our cult too. But
yes, it's a good cult.
You know, it says, you know, you're in a cult if, like, once you join, that's all you talk about. Right? And then you get other people to join, but, like, in a good way, CrossFit like that too. Everybody's been so cool. Like, Kelly and Chris are both agents down here. EXP is kind of smaller down here, but I reached out to him from the get-go. And honestly, a lot of people don't believe this. I am definitely an introvert. And so having to, like, go after people and, like, reach out to them first is very intimidating to me. But we have met. They have been great. Kelly was out of town. Chris had a COVID exposure. So, yeah, it was like, if I hadn't reached out to them, she wouldn't have been able to say, hey, can you take these people? And I was really just taking them as a favor to her for being out of town. But she had not met with them before. And we actually found them the house. And Lord, I think we looked at like 20 houses in 2 days. And we just, like, really clicked. And Kelly was like, you've done all the work. And I had not really even met them. So if you just want to take it from here, like, that's fine. We'll just do, you know, a referral fee, which I thought was awesome. Because, you know, Kelly, as an established agent, knew that I was new and knew that I had put the work in. And so she just wanted to support me. And her and I are actually going to, she invited me to go look at this open house for realtors for this, like, bougie $2.7 million home. So I'm like, can I find a buyer for this? Before
I go. And I have no doubt you can do it. So kind of like behind the scenes stuff for the agents that are watching this is, so I introduced Erin to Kelly whenever you were moving down there, because I knew Kelly was our agent in Dothan and would take care of Erin buying a house. So everything always comes full circle. Your relationships are going to be the most important thing in your business as a brand new agent. So on your other lead systems, right? You've got your other ones under contract from Op City.
Yes, I have two under contract. Oh, that's Denver, so she may join in our call. She's my unofficial office suite mate. But yeah, I have two from Op City that are two from Op City, and then one was the Kelly referral, and then another one is from our friend's referral. So yeah.
So it is possible as a brand new agent to start getting those referrals coming in. And so share with us a little bit of how you've been visible and what you're doing to kind of, you know, meet people in an area that you don't know anyone yet.
So I've definitely tried to take a page out of your playbook. I know that Jenny was our agent in Birmingham, and I probably wouldn't be in real estate if it wasn't for Jenny. So it was just all divine intervention there, right? I've watched you over the years and how you do things and how you market. And in my mind, you're not like a traditional realtor. You think outside the box. I know that when we met you and you sold our first home with us, we were just super impressed how you're not just going to take pictures, throw it up on the MLS, or just take you around, show you some homes, and then like we don't hear from you. You're definitely a part of it. You think outside the box. I was always impressed with how, like, no matter where we were, I heard from you like once a week just to be like, hey, you know, just wanted to touch base with you. So it didn't feel like, oh, hey, you were just in it for the paycheck, you know? And right. Through that, we built a relationship with you. And so I kind of want to do that here. I don't want to be just a traditional realtor. I want people to know that, like, I want to be a part of the community. I want to reach out. I want to think outside the box. You know, if I get the opportunity to have a listing, I'm not just going to throw some crappy iPhone pictures up and stick a for sale sign in the yard and wait for somebody to bring me the buyer. Heck, I want to find the buyer, you know? And so you have that page that's like Lifelong 280, and just being new here, I was like, okay, how can I help other people and help like small businesses? And then also just get my name out there. And I started a Facebook page called Connect My City, and I've just been like reaching out to people. Hey, can I interview you? I think your, you know, store or brand or whatever you're selling or doing is super cool. And I've had 5 interviews so far. We've gotten anywhere from like on the low end, like 400 views to 1500 views on our video. And it's doing pretty well. So I've actually been able to connect other people in businesses through that. And it's just nice, because all I'm saying is, hey, it literally has nothing to do with me. I'm just saying it's sponsored by me. So I just want people to know that I'm here to support local business and be a part of the community. And hopefully get some people that says, hey, I think I saw that crazy realtor on that Facebook page. She was supporting that business. I'm going to give her a call.
Well, I think it's just so important what you're doing, because that's how you get to know people. That's how you get to, we have to be ambassadors for the place that we sell. It's our home too. And the small businesses provide the amenities for where we choose to live. So right. Supporting them, I think, is super important. So I love that. And if somebody, what was the name of it again, so that people can
Connect
find it?
Connect My City. Yep.
Perfect. So anything else that you could say has, aside from your work ethic, you know, you share what you did previously.
So I was a registered nurse for 7 years, and then I went on and I got my master's degree as a nurse practitioner, and I was a family medicine nurse practitioner for 4.5 years. I did traditionally, I practiced women's health. So I did that. The last job I had was in Birmingham at a breast cancer clinic. And that's pretty much all we did, was that and breast disorders. And I loved it. And that was really hard leaving that and moving here. But I just kind of felt like it was time to kind of step out on faith and try something different. And I definitely feel that medicine has prepared me, not necessarily in the knowledge sense. I can't translate, you know, things I've learned, like diagnosing people. But learning to read people, learning to that bedside manner, just definitely rolls into how you treat people, how you work with clients. To me, I've told all my clients, I'm going to treat like a patient, you know, and I'm going to care for you, and I'm going to do the best job representing you that I can. And I'm going to treat you like I did my patient that had breast cancer, you know. And that's just kind of how I handle it. I try to, you know, of course, everybody does stuff for, you know, nobody wants to work for free, like I said. And of course, you go into jobs for money, but I really do enjoy helping people. And so I've just translated this as to either, you know, I'm helping people either buy or sell their home. And, you know, for most people, that's one of the biggest milestones in their life. And for a lot of people, that's the single biggest purchase they will ever make. And that's definitely not something to take for granted. And, you know, I don't want people to think I'm looking at them as a paycheck. I definitely want them to look like, you know, I want them to go back and be like, that was an awesome experience. Cause I know most of us can remember bad experiences, you know, buying or selling homes or buying or selling anything, a car or a horrible experience. You know, it's stressful when you buy a house, it's stressful when you sell a house. So I just want people to be able to enjoy that and know that somebody's there holding their hand the whole way.
Well, and you have really taken ownership of your responsibility, protecting your clients as well, and making sure that you give really good advice. And I'm so proud of you for that, because you're like, no, we've got to get this electrical done. You know, she's going to be faced with this.
I feel like I just have had to not be afraid of the word no. I know everybody is, but I just kind of keep telling myself, like, well, I'm never going to hear a yes if I focus on the no's. Like, if I'm too afraid to ever ask, then it is always going to be no, right? Like, if I don't give myself
no without asking.
Exactly. Like, then I'm just in the exact same boat I'm already in. So, like, especially in this market, you worked with me on asking for those corrections. And man, I went kind of, you know, I hate to say it this way, I kind of went ballsy on asking for stuff. But like, this client of mine, I just like really connected with her. And I just had something in me. Like, I've got to make this right for her. And I just went out on the limb. And, you know, of course, working kindly with your opposing realtor is always going to favor you, you know. So it ended up working out. And if I would have never asked, if I'd have been like, oh, in this market, girl, they're going to drop us like a hot potato. Like, you know, this contract is over before it started, but they didn't. They actually are pretty much correcting the major things that need to be corrected, which ensures safety for my client from here on out as she's in the home. So,
well, one last question. We could talk forever just because, you know, I mean, this is just a huge success story that right out of the gate, you're able to have four under contract. And I mean, you've got four closings in November.
I do. Four closings in November. I have sticky notes all over my office wall of like how I've done like a timeline, so I'm not like missing stuff.
Well, and many experienced agents can't claim that, Erin, and that's why I wanted to make sure to highlight you and share, you know, what it is that you're doing to be able to get this. So a lot of people that have complained about Op City and the leads that Op City sends, you know, how are you getting them to show up for a buyer consultation? What are you saying to people?
This is literally like I have pretty much the same. I've kind of gotten my personal script down, and I don't ever want to come off salesy. You know, people hate salesmen. Like, and I know that's what we are, and you are trying to sell yourself. I just try to come off genuine so they can kind of get a vibe for who I am. And I seriously just had one yesterday that I claimed. We're meeting Saturday. This is what I tell people. I'm like, hey, I'm Erin, you know, tell me about, you know, okay, you're wanting to buy, you know, I kind of ask them the questions, get a feel for them. Okay, you're not pre-approved. And this is what I just say. I'm like, this is what I like to do. This is who I am. I like to meet with everyone. I'm going to walk you through the home buying process. I'm going to walk you through the buyer's agency. You know, if you want to do it either Zoom or FaceTime or in person, because I want to see and meet these people and get a feel for them. And then if they're not pre-qualified, I send them a list of lenders who I personally know and have talked to and networked with. I usually send them a list, and I'm like, okay, I can't go show you a house until I know what you're pre-approved for, because the last thing I want you to do is fall in love with something that you can't afford, because I've done that. A lot of people have done that. And then it's like nothing ever else will measure up. You know, first we got to see where we're working with. And I want you to know exactly how much you want to spend a month, because sometimes that conflicts with exactly what you're pre-approved for.
Right.
And then I'll walk them through the home buying process, because being new and working with Op City, most of the people I'm dealing with have never bought a home, and they don't know. And so I just kind of sit down, talk, get to know them. And it usually has been 15 to 30 minutes. I give them the paperwork, and they normally, I don't make them sign right there. I'm like, look, I get it. You know, finding a realtor is like a marriage or dating. Just because you date with someone doesn't mean you're going to click and that's the person you want to work with. And they always end up calling, or I even have one couple, they said, send me that we did at Zoom. They're like, send me the papers now. Like, we don't want to interview anybody else. Let's go. So, so that's just kind of how I do it. I just don't want people to feel pressure, because it's a stressful enough situation. And a lot of people don't know where they're coming. I've wasted a lot of time, I think, out of my claims. If I go back and look, because it does your history, I think I have, like, I don't know, 25, 30 claims, you know, and I'm only working right now with, I've got two out of those that are under contract. But I just learned, what they say, Thomas Edison was asked, like, it took him over like 900 tries to invent the light bulb. And when he asked, why didn't he give up? He just said he found 900 ways how not to make a light bulb.
Well, and one other thing too, that you met a neighbor when you went to preview a house.
Yes.
Ended up.
She's like my bestie now. She's like my grandma down here.
Yeah. And so that's what y'all, it is all about relationships. And you were fearless about talking to the neighbor, and ended up leading into another real estate situation. So opportunity is everywhere. And if you're a brand new agent watching this, Erin is a star, of course, a star student. And
I don't know if I would say that, but thanks. I have to give it up for getting in the mentor program. Don't be afraid to reach out to your mentor. Jenny, if she shows you the list of texts she has from me since I've started, dear God, it probably has at least 1 gigabyte on her phone.
But it's all good stuff. And I'm super happy. Just like what you tell your clients, that you've gotten permission. Now this is permission to blow my phone up, right? I'm giving you permission to blow my phone up.
Right.
And
that's what I tell them. I'm like, we are now a partnership. I said, literally, you're now employing me. And my job is to answer all those texts, blow my phone up, you know, whereas if you're just a customer, like, we don't really owe each other anything. Because I've had them, they're like, you know, I tried to work with this other agent this realtor, and they wouldn't answer my calls. I said, did you have a buyer's agreement? Well, no, they just showed me a house before, you know.
Yeah, there you go. They weren't serious. They were a one-night stand.
Right, exactly.
We're looking for long-term relationships here.
That's right.
So I've had the pleasure to work for you several times, and now I have the pleasure of supporting you. So that's my dream come true, and I just can't wait to see what you're going to do and how you're going to grow and build and Dothan. So y'all,
I definitely have to give it up to EXP too. All the education that they have. And don't be afraid to go in EXP world and meet people and talk to your brokers and go to these classes and hit up all the free stuff. Like, it's been, I asked Jenny, I was like, I don't know how new agents do it without EXP, because I mean, all the realtors in EXP are just awesome that I've come in contact with. I have made connections in California and Florida. I mean, you're great, of course, as my mentor. Zach, I've blown up Zach. Hey, Zach Kennedy, I've blown up Zach's phone a ton while you're on vacation. It's like, Zach. And of course, he's helped me, you know, and it's not like he gets anything out of it other than just he's been there before, you know. So I just think EXP is great, and all the agents that are a part of it just seem to really want to help other agents. So,
well, we're super proud of you. And tell everybody how they can reach you if they have a referral for Dothan.
You can do it through my email. It's my name. It's Erin, Erin dot Ponds, Ponds, like the face cream, unfortunately not related, at exprealty.com. You can call me or text me 205-602-6580. You can go to my website, erinponds.com. That's pretty easy. Or you can harass Jenny and she'll build it to me.
I am happy to. And Zach actually posted in the notes how to follow Erin at Connect My City. So
yes, and my other, you know, my Facebook page is a realtor just Erin Pines at EXP Realty. So,
well, I love it. Thank you for being here today. I know
thanks,
you've
Jenny.
Got a lot of stuff going on. Find a buyer for that 2.7.
I know, right? That'd be so bothered. Like, I have arrived.
Well, it's you just got going, so you already have arrived. So we're going to celebrate through November for every closing that you have, all four of them, and I'll be here when you need me. So everybody that watched, thanks. We are super proud to help agents get a real estate life, and Erin definitely already has a real estate life. So
join EXP.
Thanks so much, Erin.
Thanks. Bye.